need somebody like me. This is a review of a certain dividend stock that I think could become a dividend trap in the next coming years. Pero I think magiging maganda siya in the future, but I don't see na maganda siyang bilhin within the next few years. So we're going to take a look at the fundamentals of this company and see at what price ko siya bibilhin that can give me that at least or desired 10% year on year for the next few years. And this free content is brought to you by the sponsors of my channel, Patreon, and YouTube. Become a sponsor and get access to exclusive perks. My personal stock research tool that I use to build my retirement portfolio of balance, dividends, and capital appreciation. And the company to cover for today is Manila Water MWC, which is part of the mid-cap index. I think looks like it's becoming a dividend trap. My own opinion only. Pero malayo kasing nangyari dito right now na wala siyang ginagawang expansions. So here are some recent articles of Manila Water. So gusto niya daw mag-invest ng 81.5 billion the next coming years to ensure 24/7 na supply. Meron silang 37.3 massive wastewater projects na gusto rin gawin. Di wala kung saan nila kukunin yung mga cash na yan. Obviously, sa utang. Spending 833 million for Rizal expansion. So, meron sila dito 181 billion service improvement plan for 2023 to 2027. Diba? Grabe mag-capex to, guys. Mas malala pa sa telco. So, for the next 3 years pala, it looks like puro aggressive expansion yung gagawin nito. So, they're able to secure a 3 billion loan to fund its expansion initiatives. So, 10-year term loan facility with Land Bank of the Philippines. And ito na yung kanyang latest article, yung kanyang performance of 2022, which is 61% increase in earnings. So in the future, para saan goods naman to, Manila Water, kasi nasa utility sector siya eh. Pero for now, I don't like the stock na papakita ko sa inyo later on bakit. So ito yung kanyang latest article, 61% increase in 2022. So 5.9 billion of net income attributed to a growth in build volumes in both East Zone Concession and other Philippine ventures. 11% increase in revenue, 22.8 billion. Of the company's other Philippine ventures, Boracay Water experienced the highest jump in build volumes at 51%, followed by Cebu Water with 29%. Looking forward, Manila Water is well positioned to continue its growth trajectory as it leverages its strong position in the Philippine market. The company has demonstrated its ability to navigate challenges as evidenced by positive results in the face of a difficult economic environment. Actually, yung mga utility, dapat they're strong. Yun naman talaga, that they're strong in any kinds of economic environment. Kasi nga, there are necessities. Diba? Kailangan sila ng tao. So, despite any economic challenges dyan, dapat maganda talaga sila. Ngayon, here's my fundamentals analysis of MWC. So, 52 billion in market cap. Kaya kabilang yan sa ating mid-cap index. So, growth overview, revenue increasing, yes. Actually, na-break na yan yung kanyang pre-pandemic na 21 billion lang. Net income is also increasing or nag-recover na, pero highest niya is 6.5 billion na most likely ma-break niya yan this year. And eto na nga ba yung sinasabi ko kanina, no? Ito yung masama sa mga dividend investor. Kasi the cash flows are declining or negative. So, madami siyang ginagawa na expansion. Natural lang na, no? Magiging cash burning yan. especially for the next few years. Or, baka naman mag-materialize yung minus plan niya dati, baka mag-positive siya. So, we'll have to find that out the next coming quarters. Pero so far, I don't like these numbers na nakikita ko sa kanya in terms of its cash flows. Liquid assets, ano, pababa rin from 21 billion naging almost 9 billion na lang. So, siguro yan niya kinukuha yung kanyang pamimigay ng dividends kasi nga, wala eh. Saan niya kukunin yung pamimigay niya ng dividends? Negative cash flows nga siya. Free cash flow, of course, declining. Massive debt na na-trim down nila dati. So, nasa 15 pala dati, short term, naging 7 na lang. Pero it looks like, pangat ulit. And with the aggressive expansion na gagawin niya, 2023 to 2027. Eto, I would say, angat pa ulit to the next coming years. So, total debt, ayan, pangat pa rin, 94 billion. And shares outstanding. This is a share diluting company. Kasi nga, ayan o, naliligo sa utang. Bleeding in cash. Therefore, para makapag-raise siya ng mga additional capitals or siguro pag nag-acquire siya ng mga asset, pina-fund niya yon through share issuance. Yun lang yung choice niya eh. Ayan o, massive share dilution. Debt to EBITDA, patas ng pataas. I want this to be below 3. So, malayong malayo pa sa katotohanan. So, this company is a very high leverage company. Pero parang okay lang, di ba? Kasi nasa utility sector siya eh. Kailangan siya ng tao. So, papautahin talaga yan. And bibigyan niya ng mataas na leverage. And eto na nga yung checklist ko sa company. So, namumula. Price to cash, negative. Na multiples, increasing revenue. Yes, pero the rest are red na red. So, share dilution, 17.6%. Grabe naman. Peak and current ratio, 0.6. ROIC, 3.4%. Quarterly, okay. There's some momentum, revenue, net income. Pataas, cash flows, pababa. And dividends, ito na nga, no. Ayan, oh. So, 2 billion dati. 2021, binaba niya. And I believe 2022 or last year, binaba niya ulit. And this year, I wouldn't be surprised kung ibaba niya ulit. Ang kanilang average 3 years of dividend yield is 1.98% only or 1 billion of payout na I would say hindi niya kayang bayaran. Pwede niyang bayaran, di ba, hugot siya rito sa kanyang liquid assets. Kung yun yung trip niya. So, the dividend cover obviously is very poor. So, kapag poor, ibig sabihin niyan is that there's a big tendency na i-cut niya yung kanyang dividends. It's either i-decrease niya yung kanyang dividends or di mo na siya mamimigay, di ba? And as you can see here, 2019, 4% yield. 2020, hindi namigay. 2021, namigay. 2.7. 2022, last year, 1.9. 2023, this year, I would say, bumaba ulit yan. There's a big chance. Or, there's also a big chance na hindi mo na siya mamigay this year. So, for dividend investors, that's basically a nightmare. Ngayon, ang sunod dapat is the valuation of this company. Pero, hindi ko ito ma-value because of negative multiples. And because of that, kapag ganyan na may negative multiple, hindi ko na yan tinitingnan, di ba? Hindi ko na yan pinagbabalaan na bilhin. Ganun lang yun kasimple. And aantayin ko na magkaroon ng clear reversal. Yung tipong kaya ko na siyang i-value para meron akong reference point, di ba? Kasi pag ganyan, automatic ang valuation niya sa akin is zero. Ibig sabihin, ignore or stay away. Ayan, if you look at the price action of this company, so tumaas, bumaba, tumaas. I wouldn't be surprised kung bumaba ulit to its all-time low, di ba? Yung nakikita ko dyan. Unless, may biglang mag-materialize na mga projects niya in the past and mag-positive yung kanyang cash flows in the next few quarters, then maybe, baka lang, baka gumanda siya. And lastly, pipin ko na yung naging napakagandang one-pager stock analysis. Accessible to all the sponsors of my channel. And that's my analysis of MWC na goods yan in the future. Kung baka parang Meralco lang yan eh, na pang defensive play. Pero ako lang, tatapusin ko muna lang tapusin yung mga project niya. Yung tipong nag-aantay na lang siya ng mga cash flows na dumarating. Di ba? Yun yung aantayin ko na stage nung company. For now, di ko muna siya gagalawin. That's it. Thank you and bye-bye. Like, subscribe.